When did you do your shopping spree?
I went shopping...
Thursday or Friday?
Thursday...
After the show, right?
No. Friday and Saturday.
Friday and Saturday. Went to... I cannot even believe I'm about to say what I'm about to say.
Yes.
We've been together for 10 years.
Uh-huh.
Your wardrobe used to consist of very ratty sneakers.
Mm-hmm.
I think the same black blue jeans.
More
or less.
Could be, sure.
And concert t-shirts.
Well,
this is how you dress
video for game t-shirts.
Video game t-shirts?
Yeah, I had a lot of t-shirts with video game logos on them and stuff.
You had a lot of freebie t-shirts that, from people that came by in the early days of our show, whether it was a concert t-shirt or a liquor company. I think you had
a lot of
you had a Jack Daniels shirt that you used to wear.
Smirnoff.
That was pretty much your wardrobe, right?
Yeah.
I'm not
true.
Going out.
Yes.
I'm not getting crazy here.
A lot of beer shirts, Bud.
Now, in the last few years, you've definitely upped your wardrobe in general.
Sure.
Okay.
Sure.
But you took it to a whole new level in L.A. as you had a shopping spree on Rodeo Drive. Look at Jim's face.
Jimmy's disgusted with me. Oh. Oh. Jimmy's disgusted with me. Yes, I went down to Rodeo.
And I just before you start your story, I thought I was getting a little crazy outrageous because I almost picked out a $172 shirt.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wait till you hear how much Anthony spent on Rodeo Drive.
Walk through it, though. The big Escalade limo picks you up.
No. I decided it's L.A., so you need a car in L.A. It's not like New York. No public transportation to speak of, really.
Dude.
So I rented a car.
All right. Well, we could start with the car then, because I'm in the lobby.
Rented a car.
I'm in the lobby waiting for them to, drive my car up, because it's L.A. and I got a couple days. I'm going to enjoy, I wanted to go down to Venice Beach and do all sorts of stuff in L.A., so I'm waiting for my car, and I rented a brand-new Nissan. Brand new. It had literally 20 miles on it.
Uh-huh.
I was pretty happy with my rental. And as I'm waiting for my car, Anthony comes down, and at this point he sees my rental, and he goes, oh, you rented a car too? I go, yeah. He goes, I rented a car as well. I'm like, really? What'd you rent?
I rented a nice car.
What'd you rent? A Nissan or Saturn, maybe? Like old Jimmy Norton drives?
Dude, times have changed, is all I'm saying.
I rented the Mercedes-Benz SLK sports car. This thing was an animal.
It was a hard top convertible.
Oh, yeah, how to get the convertible.
Dude, Mercedes convertible?
Dude, this is the guy that when I first met him, the only car he had was up on blocks in his front yard.
The Dodge Aries K.
Dodge Aries K car. Where when we decided we were going to move to Boston and give this radio thing a try, I'm like, dude, you know you need a car if we're moving. He goes, yeah, I got a car. I'm like, where? And he points to a car in the weeds that's up on blocks.
Hey,
this is the guy I met.
Or two.
Fast forward 10 years. I'm getting ready to jump in my brand new Nissan.
Brand new Nissan. Dude, you had everyone's mom's car. That was the worst car I'd ever seen. It was a car that was, it had sensible window area. Like where there's no blind spot on this car. You know, it was probably the worst car in Beverly Hills.
And that's the point I'm going to make. I was beyond embarrassed because then they pull Anthony's car up.
Oh, my rocket ship comes up from valet.
And they park
and it's
it.
Like, vroom, 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 vroom. The valet parks it in front.
And they park it right next to my car.
Yeah.
Right next to me. And I was, I mean, you got to give me a little credit. I got Anthony into this business, and now he's showing me up really bad. Really bad. Where I had to go to the valet, yeah, he might have a better rental, but I have a bigger dick.
And that's not even true if you go by reactions behind vehicles in Boston.
I know. Yeah, honestly, we haven't had the dick off yet, and I'm a little worried to ever have that. But
we each get into our respective vehicles,
and I'm like, please just drive away now. You're embarrassing the shit out of me.
As Opie's adjusting the huge rear view mirror, that's sensible and safe. I'm putting the top down
on his hard top Mercedes convertible.
Oh, and it folds right into the trunk. It's wonderful. Not the old days where you used to have to unclip the top from the thing. You press a button, that top comes right down. I got the radios blasting, and this thing, boom, boom, boom. It sounds great.
But logically, where were you driving to? I mean, we were both stuck in traffic.
You know something? I don't know where I was going. I don't know for how long. But goddamn, I was doing it in style, motherfucker.
So you went to hit the button. Now, Ope would have hit the button if it weren't driving at 10 o'clock, 2 o'clock.
Dude, hit the button. I had to adjust my mirrors with my hand. What button? There were no buttons.
Oh my goodness.
How much was the Nissan a day?
I don't know. Honestly, I don't know. Probably like $50, I guess.
He gets a $50 rental.
It was just to get me around.
Dude, you're driving around in Beverly Hills. It's like...
Dude, you rolled your eyes. Shut up.
You gotta... You're with me on this.
No, I'm not.
Rolled your eyes.
The sign says Opie and Anthony. You guys, you have to ride around in a stylish vehicle.
You gotta have a little style. You're only there for a few days.
Right.
So for those few days, you might as well live it up a little bit. You know what I mean? You know, live it up a bit.
Well, the Mercedes is probably at least $75 a day.
Could be.
Right, $50 a day for the Nissan. And
could have been. That was, about 75 a day.
Was it really for the
Mercedes?
Sure. Okay.
Yeah, it's
times,
cheap.
Times three or four.
Yeah, double, quadruple that, whatever it is.
Plus, of course, you have to take out the insurance on that.
Oh, I wasn't. I was initialing everything. Yeah, if I trash this thing.
I didn't have to initial anything.
This spaceship's taking out three poles if I hit one. Believe me. Oh, opened it up. This thing sounded and ran. It was really fast, great. And even in Beverly Hills, it got looks. Well, you didn't see many around, you know? A lot of Caddies, a lot of Porsches. They have a lot of those Cayenne SUVs driving around. A couple of Ferraris even going around. But that thing, so low to the ground. I'm used to a big SUV, so very close to the ground, pretty cool. And, yeah, why not? I figured, why not? If you're going to drive around...
Oh, I have no problem with what you do until it's, like, shoved in my face with my little Nissan right next to it.
Dude, your car was the worst car. I swear to you, it was one of those.
And I remember thinking to myself, I used to be the rock star in this relationship. What happened to me? Now I'm like a grandma compared to him.
Did you use Enterprise Rental?
I don't know.
The same company.
I just started this one.
You probably
could have
gotten at least the Mustang convertible.
Did you go to Enterprise, Anthony?
You could. I tried, but they didn't have anything really good.
They had the Enterprise.
Oh, there you go. Well, they didn't have anything good left because somebody took the last Toyota Corolla.
That's a Nissan.
Well, wait a minute. Now, here on the Mike Brady and Anthony show,
it was
chicks with big tits and sensible rentals.
That was the most sensible rental I've ever seen in my life was Opie's car he had out there.
I didn't even think twice about it until your fucking rocket pulls up.
He's driving around Beverly Hills and you're looking for passenger airbags. What a goody two-shoes.
Oh, Jesus.
I didn't even think twice, man. I was like, it was all about the destination, not how I got there.
How you got there? No, it's just how often... Am I going to drive around in one of those?
Yeah.
So screw it. Why not? Go ahead. And I'm doing a little shopping on Rodeo, so I figured I'd pull up in that.
So you went on Rodeo Drive. You must have dropped $300-$400 on Rodeo Drive.
Oh,
easy,
yeah.
Man.
It was $300-$400.
Look,
easy.
Look, this is the beauty of the radio show, okay?
Yeah.
Who's in the barrel right now?
Who?
Am I in the barrel for enjoying myself?
No. I didn't say you were.
Taking a little...
I did not say you were. You'll be stepping into that barrel in a mere moment here.
All right.
But I just want to make sure everyone understands that, yes, I, Opie, am in the barrel right now.
Oh, a little bit.
But by the end of this break, I think they're going to forget all about my rental.
A little bit in the barrel.
They're going to forget all about my rental. Yeah,
really?
I think so.
All right. I don't think so. I see the Photoshop's being done right now on Wackberry.
Open a station wagon, all these Revenge of the Nerd car.
It's the family truckster.
All right. So,
you
parked your Mercedes, what?
I parked my Mercedes in front of Bernini on Rodeo.
Mm-hmm.
It was getting a little late. All the clothiers on Rodeo close at 6 o'clock, but Bernini stays open.
You call them what?
Clothiers. All the clothiers on Rodeo. All the stores on Rodeo, they...
They're called
Clothier.
What's a Clothier?
It's a clothing store. The Clothier.
That's what you call the Gap?
No, that's the Gap.
Oh.
This is Bernini on Rodeo in Beverly Hills, Opie.
Oh, my God.
So Hugo Boss in there. And
we really should, like, just end this show on top.
Well.
Because this is jumping over the shark type thing.
I was right there. I was going
to. Jumping the shark moment.
It's not like I'm going out to Fifth Avenue here to continue my shopping spree. I was there. Our hotel was in Beverly Hills. I had rented a nice vehicle. I figured we'd go shopping on Rodeo. And why not? You're there.
Because you're going to get such great bargains there.
Well, of course you're not shopping for the bargains. It's like a tourist attraction.
Yeah.
You just kind of go there to...
They don't jack up the stuff because they know people are going...
Of course they do.
They don't jack it up 300%, do they?
I could get the same stuff for dirt cheap, I'm sure. But you don't get it with that atmosphere.
Well, take us along on your shopping.
Pull up right in front.
Is there a spot right in front?
Of course there is.
I have to ask, Ope, did you have a problem finding a spot in front of Daffy's?
Did you have a valet?
No, I parked myself.
I was feeding the meter.
Parked myself.
On a side street.
Right in front. Oh, on a side street?
Oh, yeah. I didn't want anyone...
Seeing you in that?
To see me actually step out of this thing.
Of
I'm
course
not stupid.
Not. And I get out, and I'm greeted at the door by Tony. Tony is at the door. Ah, come on in. We're going to show you around. This fine Italian gentleman is showing me around the store, pointing out some things that I might like to wear. Some Hugo Boss attire and maybe some Versace pants and shirts and just wonderful things, a nice jacket. You know, things I would wear out, not things I'd wear here to work.
Sure.
But if I'm going out, or perhaps, Opie, if we're doing one of those TV interviews that I wear crap on a lot, maybe I could dress a little nicer and wear some of the stuff I picked up on Rodeo. Right? Picked up a nice jacket and shirts and pants.
A sports jacket or like a leather jacket?
I was looking for a nice leather jacket, which they had a lot of, but not quite the style. I think I might go down to Fifth Avenue and try to buy a nice leather.
Of course.
Could continue my shopping like I said I wasn't going to do.
All right.
No, and a nice jacket that I would wear with a nice casual shirt underneath. You know, casual, stylish, but, you know, sort of not dressed like a suit or anything like right. that. So I picked that up. And tried them all on in the dressing room. Some things had to be fitted. Some things had to be tailored. Okay. And they do it right there. The old guy comes out, measures, takes it in the back room, and tailors this stuff right there on the spot. That's the service you get in there in Beverly Hills when you go shopping there. That's what I was there for, the experience.
The pants you had to have tailored and the jacket as well?
Yeah. You know, they take it to it right there, back room.
So that pair of pants, that's got to cost you. A pair of pants like that's got to run $100. I'm not even kidding.
Oh, probably at least. If I checked the receipts and saw how much I spent, it was probably well over $200-$300.
So you got a pair of pants. That's nice.
Pair of pants, three, four, maybe five shirts.
Nice.
Nice sports jacket type.
Nice. Sports jacket?
Well, no, it's sort of like a dress jacket, you know, that you'd wear, but not with a suit and tie kind of thing. Kind of with a nice dress shirt. Yeah? What are you making a face for?
What?
Yeah, what?
Hope bought something similar, but it was actually the T-shirt with the tuxedo painted onto it.
I really got to learn how to enjoy myself.
Maybe you should.
I'm trying, Anthony. I really am.
You really should. You should.
All right, so you have a
dust
pair
of... Dust off the old wallet every so often and have a little fun.
A pair of pants.
Yeah.
What else again?
Five shirts.
Are you upping that so it doesn't sound as bad? We're all about honesty on this show.
I'm thinking. Two button, a couple of pullovers. Maybe four shirts.
All right. Four shirts.
Four shirts.
One pair of pants, four shirts. What else?
A jacket.
A jacket.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what else?
And a pair of shoes. Got some shoes.
Bruno Mali's?
Nice Italian shoes.
Pair of shoes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
One shoes.
Yeah.
All right. And this Tony character helped you out using the chalk, sizing you up.
Oh, yeah. Tony was a great help coming over, showing me, look how good this color go with this. It was wonderful. A personalized service from Tony.
All right. Mm-hmm. I'm going to guess. Can I take a quick guess? I'm going to guess. This is my guess.
Uh-huh.
The total Anthony spent. $250 on the jacket.
$250 on the jacket.
All right. All right.
$150 on the shoes. $150 for a nice pair of shoes. That's right. $400. And then you're going to have a bunch of very expensive shirts. $125 each. So I'm going to say the total for those four shirts, $500. So the total, I'm going to guess, I'm going to say $900.
Well, plus the pants. You forgot the pants. So
you're right. So for a good pair of pants.
$100 to $100. Mm-hmm.
I'd say $170 for pants.
All right. So you're.
$1,070.
$1,070.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
Wow.
I know that's a little high for the pants.
Wow.
$170. Mm-hmm. But I spent like $100 once on a pair of Diesel
jeans. I think that's fair, actually. $1,070 for all that.
$1,070.
Knowing it's Rodeo Drive.
Uh-huh. Sure.
And the Mercedes joking around. How many days did you have it?
2 days.
Okay, so I'm going to joke. I was kidding before. But I'm going to say with the insurance, $140 a day, 2 days, $280. So that's a grand total of... $1,350 for the car and the shopping spree.
All right,
but I know how much you spent on the clothes, and then we have to factor in the car. So why don't we? I don't want to confuse people. So let's do it in two categories, okay?
Uh-huh.
You think his clothes, and this isn't Jimmy being, silly. You think, fair enough that he spent $1,070 on the clothes.
Yeah,
Anthony, how much did you spend on Rodeo Drive on those clothes?
$2,500.
$2,500.
Yeah, $2,500.
People are starting to forget about my Nissan. I told you. That's why I went into the barrel first, ladies and gentlemen.
Uh-huh.
I'm a radio genius.
Uh-huh.
$2,500.
$2,500.
$100.
Yeah. But you got to see these clothes. They're wonderful.
Why, do they have cash in the pockets?
Yeah, perhaps it was splurging a bit. Sure.
I guarantee, out of all that stuff you bought, a couple of those things you'll never even wear.
It could be. We'll see. I'll wear them out. I'll wear them when we're going someplace nice.
So $2,500 for the clothes.
Uh-huh.
And then the car rental.
Car rental, right.
Mm-hmm. Was at least, with the insurance and everything, what, $200 a day?
Yeah, probably $230 a day.
$230 a day.
Mm-hmm.
2 days. Yeah. So just under $3,000.
Yeah. There you go.
All right.
he's disgusting.
No, I'm not at all. Dude, I sold about 30 CDs when I was in Houston. That actually is not that bad when you break it down. When you break down $4,000 or $5,000 or $3,000 or whatever, that's...
You know what it is?
It's not that bad.
I figured that the XM put us up in a hotel.
Yeah, a nice hotel.
A nice hotel. They fly us out there. They do. This is free. You know what I mean?
It's
one of those.
That's actually not... I underestimated, but that's actually not... For a shopping spree in Rodeo Drive and a great car like that, $3,000-$4,000 is a lot of money, but for a vacation type thing like that...
I don't do this on a daily basis.
Right.
I come back to New York, I live like a slob.
Anthony
is... But when I go out, and then dinner, I like having a little, what they call the champagne.
When do we get the fashion show where you come in here and show us what you bought?
Never. How about never?
Why? I'm sure they could put some music to it.
I'm sure you could. You have that image, dream going about in your head on a nightly basis, Jimmy, because that's the only way you're
ever
going
to RuPaul. Hear that. Yeah, a little RuPaul.
RuPaul.
Oh, right.
Supermodel or whatever that stupid song is called.
I strut my stuff.
Yeah, let's go to the phones. I'm sure no one really has much to say here. Let's say hi to Tony in Cleveland. Hey, Tony.
Hey, Tony.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
What's up?
Hey, I didn't realize I was listening to the Opie and Anthony Stern show.
Robin.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. We all know where Stern went bad, and that's why I think we should retire now. We're starting to jump the shark here, ladies and gentlemen.
I don't know about retiring yet.
Why not? Robin.
I don't know. I think we should wait.
Yeah.
Wait till, you know, Jimmy just...
It's not about you, douchebag.
Jimmy's got a place. I'm paying for it.
Mike from Ohio. What's up, Mike?
Hey, what's going on, boys?
Hey, hey man.
Hey, I just wanted to know when Mel Acuna was going to wear his Gucci boots in, so you guys get some strawberries at him.
See, I'm not going to come into work wearing clothes like that.
Punch it out, boys.
That is for when maybe I'll go to the Broadway show.
I promise... If I ever see you in those shoes, and there's a fruit stand around, you're in trouble.
Oh, really? You're going to throw a chocolate-covered strawberry at my shoes?
Oh, no. It's going to be a big cement apple.
Yeah. Chocolate-covered watermelon just right. Shatter the ankle. Well, I want to know, when is Ant going to have like those like headphones like Charles McCord so the hair doesn't get mushy?
Oh, there you go. You know, I don't mind being in the barrel. Because I could spin it around just on what I heard that happened in California.
What?
I did splurge. I spent a lot of money. I enjoyed myself. Ben partook in a little bit of the champagne we had at dinner, you know, and they sure jacked those prices up. I tried for the Dom, which went for $200 bucks a bottle, but they didn't have any.
Partook, is that what you call grabbing the bottle and swigging out of it?
I know, Ben. That's good stuff. He was actually taking champagne and dumping it in his Guinness, telling me this is how Bono drinks it. I swear to you.
Did not.
Yeah, they call it velvet something.
Hey,
what Bono drinks.
Dustin, what's up?
What's up, fellas?
Hey.
Hey, man.
Hey, I was just wondering if Anthony was going to stop by the Hamptons and have a couple sea breezes.
I'm going to take the Howie copter out to the Hamptons, Rob.
Let's see. Brian, what's up?
Hey, guys. I didn't realize that Anthony couldn't sound gayer if he was walking around with a limp wrist and a lisp.
Is it gay to maybe partake in some shopping on Rodeo if your hotel is a mile away from it?
Not at all.
No, not at all.
Why not?
One more shirt and Andrew Cunanan would have shot you.
Wow.
Very good.
You went there. Nice. Dan from Yonkers.
Yeah. Hey, fellas.
Hey.
Anthony get a nice happy ending from Tony?
The wheels are just falling off this joke. Come on.
Guy is awful.
Dude, the phone call. We got to repeat that, dude.
Then he turns it up to hear himself.
Dude.
Dan.
Dan's gone.
Oof. What are they saying here? John from New Jersey, did the store owners turn to each other and giggle when they took your inseam? All right, well.
Hey, Ant, did Richard Gere show up with flowers and try to take you away? That's funny.
Right,
Ant went to L.A. and turned into Cher from Clueless.
Do you know, George makes a good point on the line. We don't have to go to him. He says, Ant spent Patty's entire salary in a mere few hours.
Oh. Well, like I said, I don't do it often.
Brendan from Atlantic City. Yes, Brendan.
Hey, what's going on, fellas?
Hey.
Anthony, you're a big-time shit-dick, dude.
Anthony, shit-dick!
Norton, can't wait to see you at the Borgata, baby.
Thanks, buddy. Glad you're coming.
Yeah, the Borgata sold out.
Are they going to weigh you? And if you weigh more by the end of your set, they're going to fire you?
No? Well, I actually have it in my contract where they can't weigh my whole thing, just one of my meat tits at a time.